Friends, hope you all are following social distancing, using masks and washing your hands with sanitizer to prevent you to save yourself from this global pandemic. Today, I am going to discuss with you the last member of past family, past perfect continuous tense. So without wasting time, we will start. Past perfect continuous tense, what's the structural formula for this tense? Subject plus had been, subject plus had been plus v1 plus ing plus object. This formula is for affirmative sentences. Affirmative sentences, like if I say they had been, living in Mumbai for the last 10 years, they had been, they is the subject, had been is the helping verb, had been, and living, v1 plus ing, and for last 10 year is the object, and for in Mumbai is the object, and for last 10 year is the time reference given into the sentence. While discussing present perfect continuous tense, I have told you each and everything about the use of since and for. Again, I am discussing before starting the tense. For is always used for a period of time. Period of time means 10 years. 10 years is a period of time, and long time period, for period of time we will use for, and point of time we always use since. If instead of writing for last 10 years, so if I write living in Mumbai, instead of writing it, if I write since 1975, because exact time is given, point of time is given, so we will use since, and otherwise we will use for point of time. I will write here since point of time for period of time. You have to keep these two in mind, since for point of time and for period of time. So come to this is they had been living in Mumbai since 1975. So this formula is for affirmative simple sentences. And if you have to write negative sentence, then subject plus had not been plus v1 plus ing plus object. Like Radha had been dancing. Radha had not been. You just have to add not between had and been. Radha had not been dancing since morning. Radha had not been dancing since morning. So this is this formula is for negative sentence, for negative sentence. And the last for interrogative sentence, had plus subject plus been plus v1 plus ing plus object. So had they been jumping, had they been jumping in the river river since evening or morning. Since morning. Had they been jumping in the river since morning? So had, when in every tense I used to discuss with you that when a sentence become interrogative, when a helping verb comes before the subject, same is the case in this type of sentences. The first, had they been jumping in the river since morning, this is for, and at the end question mark, this is for interrogative sentence. Interrogative sentence, this is for interrogative sentence. And how to make it negative interrogative? You just have to do had they not, then you will add. I will write the structure formula here: had plus subject plus not plus been plus v1 plus ing plus object. This formula is for negative interrogative sentence. Negative interrogative sentence. This is for negative interrogative sentence. And in past continuous and past perfect tense, there is an advantage for you. What was the advantage? That you need not to worry about that with singular subject you have to use has, with single plural subject you have to use have. There is only one helping verb, that is had. And in past perfect continuous, had been, whether the subject is singular or whether the subject is plural or plus with any name, you have to use only one helping verb, that is had been. So this is an advantage for you. And v1 plus ing, I have discussed it with you, we also call it v4. This is the fourth form of the verb, v4. So this is all from my side about the structure formula of past perfect continuous tense. Now I will discuss the use of past perfect tense, uses of past perfect tense. Listen to me, first of all, before discussing the uses with you, the first thing I want to tell you that this tense is hardly used in any sentences, but in active voice and in passive voice and in direct and indirect speech. So this tense is used. You have to change the sentences of the direct speech into indirect speech, and there are some particular rules for that when we will discuss these topics. So I will tell you each and everything about the use of, about how to change the past perfect continuous, or there is no change in the sentence, I will tell you each and everything about it. But before it, I will discuss with you the first use of past perfect continuous tense. Past perfect continuous tense, to express an action that begins before a certain time. To express an action that begins a certain time before, to express an action that begins a certain time in past and continued means, now it continued in past also, continued up to that time and, or you can say, or just before it, or just before it. With example you will understand it in a more better way. So with example, the students had been shouting for 10 minutes. If I say the students had been shouting for 10 minutes. The students had been shouting for 10 minutes when the vice principal reached the class, reach the class. First of all, read the rule again that I have written on the board. To express an action that begin a certain time in past, means the student had been shouting. Student had been shouting for 10 minutes. They continued their shouting for 10 minutes, and when the vice principal arrived and continued up to the time just before it. Just before it, listen to me. When the principal arrived in the class, before that, students are shouting continually for 10 minutes, but the action was finished or stopped when the principal reached in the class. Getting it or not? So, what he was trying to say, to express an action that begins a certain time. What was the certain time? They were just creating noise in the class 10 minutes before, but when the principal arrived, they stopped everything. So, until, next example is until he taught at boarding school, Kin had been teaching in a, we can say village school, city school, in a village school. So until he taught at boarding means boarding schools, residential schools. So until he taught at boarding, Kin had been teaching in a village school. So the action begins a certain time and continued just before it, and continued up to that time or just before it, means before teaching into a boarding school, he was teaching into a village school. So this is what these sentences indicate, that past perfect continuous tense is used to express an action that began a certain time in past and continued up to that time or just before it. Got it or not? Now we will discuss the second use. We will discuss the second use of past perfect continuous tense. So the second use is also very simple, like it, because this tense was very rarely used while talking or while describing the sentences. Hardly it is used, so that's why there are only few uses of this tense. So the second use is to express a repeated action in past as a continuous action. Repeated action means he was trying the same thing again and again in the sentence. If I say he had walked repeatedly, he had walked repeatedly to solve the problem. First of all, he had worked repeatedly. Repeatedly means again and again he was trying to solve the problem. So he had been working to solve the problem. He had been working means वो एक लंबे समय से इस प्रॉब्लम को सोल्व करने की ट्राई कर रहा था. सो से कर रहा था. सो दैट्स व्हाई दिस सेंटेंस इज इन पास्ट परफेक्ट कॉन्टिन्यूअस टेंस. नाउ दीज आर द ओनली टू यूजेज ऑफ दिस पास्ट परफेक्ट कॉन्टिन्यूअस टेंस. आई लास्ट थिंग आई वॉन्ट टू डिस्कस विद यू अबाउट दिस टेंस इज when article the, because I have discussed the same thing while discussing present perfect continuous tense with you, so I feel like to repeat the same thing again. When article the is given before the time references, when article the is given before the time references, so for is used, not since is used. I will teach you with examples. First of all, I will write the rule. When article the is used before time references for is used. So look at the board, everyone. Since last month, if I say since last month, no article is given. This is a time reference. When since and for comes into the sentences, they always indicate towards a point of time or period of time. Since last week, but the is not given before the time reference. If the is given, the last month, so we will use for, not since. This is the difference. And for last month, since last week, if I say since last week, but time reference article the is not given here, but if we have to use for, so for the last week, for the last week. So this is the use of past perfect continuous tense. Hope you all understand it, and if you have any query, you will ask me in WhatsApp group. Thank you. Have a nice day.